One thing that is definitely classic, and that there are whole solutions just for that, but it's all around bundling, just offering multiple products at some sort of a discount or together instead of just offering like separate products. You can do it either below the cart, like get all three together and add it to the cart. You can do it in every step of the way through the funnel. The one way that I thought that I found that works probably best eventually, and I really don't know why, but if I'm just looking at the data across 40,000 stores, the one thing that really works is just offer the same product at additional discount, and allowing them to pick a different variant or whatever. But just take another one at X percent off, one-time offer, take it or leave it. It works all across the funnel. It works on a to cart pop-up. It works at checkout. It works post purchase, and it works on the thank you page. I don't know why, but it works. Probably the easiest way to go. Another way would be to even offer like a set of two or three together at a bigger discount, but you got to take the entire thing. It is important that whenever you do these offers, you make it smart so that if they do remove the products, the discount goes as well.
And so depending on what you have and what you're bundling,
It depends on a lot of stuff.
you may have to use apps for this, but I've se seen it relatively simply done with certain products, of course, by just creating variants, right? Like, you have a variant of buy one, you have a variant of buy two, you have a variant of buy three. Oh, we got a thanks,
No,
Casey.
we're good. We're good.
It disappeared for a
But
second.
yeah, like in a variant of buy one, buy three, buy five. But yeah, I mean, of course, you can or you can create other products for it. So a lot of times you can duct tape this together without apps, but sometimes certain apps will make it a smoother process. I don't know if you have any. I don't have any like app recommendations that I would say this is all encompassing because it really depends on like what other variants you have. So for example, I work with a brand that sells pants, and pants are already a multivariant thing because we have color, we have waist size, we have length size. Right. And so we have already so many SKUs just from one product. It's hard to create another variant for like bundling. So you really have to kind of do something. You're gonna have to use some kind of apps or custom solution for bundling. So, versus bundling, phone cases or something like that where there is no real variant. But yeah, so I hesitate to like kind of make one all-encompassing app recommendation, but play with using variants to do it or just different products.
I think this one so far probably is my favorite. And John, you mentioned consumables earlier. This is also like a great way to pitch like a subscription service, depending on, that doesn't fit for every business, but if you are pitching those consumables and, why not try to offer them a subscription upsell right at the beginning? Same idea behind, buying in bulk. And we all know in e-commerce, if you get somebody on the subscription model, there's a solid chance that even if they aren't in love with your product, they just ride that subscription out for a while, and maybe they have a hot and cold relationship with your products. But on that subscription, they always have that opportunity to come back, re-engage, whether it's consumable, using more of your stuff, or whether it's pants and you get a pair of pants a month or whatever. You're always getting a new style. Maybe the new style comes in and you like it. Who knows? So,
I mean, it makes sense because you need to be active to stop the subscription and not to start it. I mean, once you start, you need to be active to make a purchase. But if you need to be active to stop the purchase, that's definitely going to be more effective. People are either lazy or they just, they have other things on their mind. Even if they don't really like it, there's a good chance they're just going to keep waiting for it.
If they don't love it, if they don't like it, then it could create some bad brand affinity. But if it's like, hey, it's not my favorite pair of pants, but when my top two are both, in the wash, that's my third, then, I would take a pair of pants every quarter probably. Also, especially if you baked into there, for men's pants, it's like, yeah, every 2 years we're gonna start sending them a higher waist size, because that's on average what's going on.
There's one, there's one thing about subscriptions that is better in terms of bundling, or if you look at it this way, is that it's not as scary as a bundle. In general, I have a personal issue with pre-purchase, upsells, and bundles and AOV increases. It's because once you go to the checkout, you have the psychology barrier that you have to go through in order to put out your credit card. It's just bigger.
Yeah,
If
you just
you
get
had,
bigger.
you just make a bigger purchase, eventually you're going to see the final number. And the beautiful thing about either post-purchase, when you do it, you don't have to commit in advance. You can just edit later. Same goes with subscriptions. You don't necessarily commit to the entire thing right then and there. You just you're going to take it by bits and bytes, small pieces. Yeah, sorry.
English. I've always said that in all, you know, at the end of the day, the post-purchase upsell will be the number one most practical thing that will raise your average order value without sacrificing your conversion rate, because your conversion rate, it should stay the same. Honestly, it's going to be, you're not doing anything different on the front end. You're just adding that post-purchase upsell, which some people are going to take. So it's just inherently going to increase your average order value. Now, the only reason it could change your conversion rate is if you have some new tool taking over your checkout, and that new tool isn't as smooth of a checkout process as Shopify. But most of the good ones like Reconvert and stuff like that, they're going to be a nice smooth checkout process. So your front end conversion rate's not going to change, but your average order value will increase. So that's, I think, like always the number one easiest, lowest hanging fruit way to increase your average order value is what we talked about in number one. Just put that post-purchase upsell in there. But yeah, I mean, some of these other things, bundling, I think they're worth testing. It's worth testing it side by side.